Dignity for all.
Thank you very much. Hello and welcome to Growing Up. Growing Up is a program designed for the youth and the upcoming generation. It is a program that avails our children the opportunity to air their stance on topics related to character development and human capacity building. This program is reaching you from Nigerian Television Authority, NTA Channel 12, WIO, your dependable station. Eme Miriam Setufe is my name. I am the host of this educative program. Today, our motion is a very interesting one. You want to know? The motion for today is extra lessons should be discouraged in our school system. Should it be? All right, you want to know, you know at the end of this program, because we have two schools here to knock horns on the motion. We have Antibasi College. Students from Antibasi College are here to propose the motion, while students from Confident Comprehensive High School, Ikorekwene, these schools are all in Akwa Ibom State. They are here to do justice to the topic. All you need to do is to just sit back, relax, and experience the delight, because it promises to be very educative, informative, and exciting. Once again, thank you for joining us. Today, we are privileged to have a very young girl as a moderator. She is from Antibasi College, Uyo. Please put your hands together as she comes on stage. You're welcome, dear.
Good day and welcome to Growing Up. My name is Anika Indiana Essien, a student of JSS 2 from Antibasi College. I'm privileged to be the moderator for today. The motion for today is extra lessons during holidays should be discouraged in our school system. We have two schools who are competing with each other. The first school, the least speaker from the first school is Shalom Adeyemi Adekunle. Also, the least speaker from the second school is Courage Emmanuel James. Now, let's get to know our panel of judges. At my extreme left is Mrs. Rosemary Ayile. Next is Mrs. Priska Udo, who is our chief judge. At my immediate left is Mr. Samuel Umba.
Today is very interesting in the house. It says extra lessons should be discouraged in our school system. And to do justice to this very important topic today is Antibasi College, U and Confidence Comprehensive High School, Ikotekwene. Rules and regulations are very easy. It says your point of information will highly be interested by the judges, and also your eye contacts, your appearance, the points raised by you, your time management, and your comportment, also your friends. Growing up,
growing integrity.
I wish you a pleasant moment. Thank you very much.
Extra lesson is a complete distraction. This could be tiring or demoralizing. As school system should not in any way be abused by the introduction of extra lessons, either during the school system or during holidays. But before I continue, I would love to pay respect to whom respect is due. Good afternoon, Mr. Chairman, my panel of judges, accurate timekeeper, my co-debaters, and my ladies and gentlemen. I, Shalom Adeyemi Adelaku, am here to propose a motion which says extra lessons should be discouraged in our school system. I would love to define some terms. Holiday. Holiday is a time for rest, relaxation, and refreshment. It's a time when students get break from after all the stress in learning. Extra lesson is the additional time in learning when students get more time in learning than the school hours. In terms of pushing students into hard work, when high school comes, students, particularly the ones taking tougher subjects, need time to relax and catch up on assignments. We have teachers who try to push students into hard work. We are human children, not machines. Time. We are still around 5 hours a week. That is the 7 hours of education and then the 5 hours of constant work. We also have 9.5 months for education and then 2 months off. I think we should have maybe 6 months of education and then 4 months of, and then 4 months of vacation. Plus when it's time for school, elementary to the middle school student, which have school 5 days a week and then 2 days off. Skipping classes and upper grades. If students allowed to be free from extra lessons, I'm sure the skipping classes won't be done. Students will always be present at school each day of school, and their grades will improve, which will benefit the teachers. The teachers will be able to prepare for the next year, and student behavior will change from bad to good. And if they are on time, they will be able to focus.
Excuse me, point of information.
Yes, go on.
Plateau may not have been able to introduce extra lessons because he was always busy in his lab doing scientific experiments, and that served as an extra lesson for him, and that is why he excelled in science.
Okay. But he himself, I'm not saying that he did extra lesson, he attended extra lesson. I'm saying that he introduced extra lesson. He didn't introduce extra lesson. If he introduced extra lesson, for sure students would have been going for extra lesson, but he himself didn't introduce extra lesson.
But the study he had in his lab, didn't that serve as an extra lesson for himself? He also encourages extra lessons.
Okay, can you give an example of the way you encourage extra lesson?
By example.
Sorry. Now, weakness and illness. Students don't get back all their energy after all the stress in learning. I'm not saying that learning is stressful, but we should try and understand that learning without fun, rest, or play can lead to mental problems. That's why you see some children on the road displaying some lunatic kind of an act. It might be because of too much reading, studying, or learning. That's why the saying goes, all work and no play makes Jack a dull boy. If children are allowed to be free from extra lessons, I'm sure all the throwing of tantrums won't be done to frustrate parents. Skipping students with low reading habit. There are some students who need 1 day off to finish whatever assignment he or she has been given if they were weak on that certain subject. There are also students who need 1 day off to prepare for upcoming tests or exams. Fun time. Students need time to have fun with family and friends instead of being bombarded with a lot of work to do during all their lessons. Students get all their lessons, most especially on Christmas period, Easter period, or whatever event. Eccles, a Greek philosopher said that education is a slavery work and a waste of time. Abraham Lincoln, the 16th American president, didn't go to school but taught himself how to read and write. Thomas Edison went to school at age 12 but was taught how to read and write at home. I didn't say extra lesson. Mr. Chairman, please permit me to ask, was it extra lesson that took you to this stage at 9? Is there any of you here that attended extra lesson during your days? Of course, no. If extra lesson is that effective, why then do we have mass failures in WAEC and JAMB? I'm sure with this point of mind, I've been able to convince you and not confuse you. I'm sure everyone's present and seated here will stand strongly to agree with me that extra lessons during holiday period should not only be discouraged, but should be abolished in our school system. Thank you.
Growing in integrity.
Growing integrity.
Dignity for all.
Now, let us all listen to
team.
Good afternoon, panel of judges, accurate timekeeper, my co-debaters, and my wonderful audience. I'm Courage Manuel James, a representative of Confidence Comprehensive High School. I'm here to oppose the motion that extra lessons should be discouraged in our school system. But before we proceed, we'd like to know what extra lessons. Extra lessons are classes organized by school after school hours. It may be free or paid, depending on the school arrangements. The reason why extra lessons should be encouraged is differentiated instructions. All students learn differently. This is a principle of inclusive education. One key teaching strategy is breaking students into small groups. By using small groups, teaching can be tailored to the way each student learns best. This is known as differentiated instruction, which can only be done in extra classes. Supportive teaching strategies. In extra classes, teachers work on specially designed instruction and support that can help the students make progress. Students are allowed to move around or use fidgets. Teachers also put positive behavioral interventions and support in place. This can help all students, not only those with learning and attention issues. Another point is reduced stigma. Extra classes are filled with diverse learners. This can give students the opportunity to explain how everyone learns in its own way. This can go a long way in reducing stigma for students with learning and attention issues. It can also help to build and maintain friendships. Effective use of resources. In extra classes, students are usually pulled out for other related services, such as speech therapy and other specialized instruction. An inclusion classroom often brings speech therapists, reading specialists, and other service providers into the classroom. These professionals provide information and suggestions that can help all students. If a student isn't eligible enough for special education but still needs some extra support, it can provide him with some informal support. The need to readjust to unfolding exigencies. With the ever-increasing workload on school students of almost all levels, especially in cases where they have to offer as many as 15 subjects with an average of 8 to 10 periods per day, spanning from 40 to 60 minutes in most schools, there is no gainsaying that it will be a near impossibility for these students.
You made mention of professionals giving students communication therapy. Please give me one example that shows that this is really happening, because I've not heard of that taking place in extra lessons.
During extra lessons, the teacher might prepare for specialists, that is, for example, in subjects like physical and health education. Professionals in that field can come and educate the students on how they can practice these sports. With the ever-increasing workload on school students of almost all levels, especially in cases where they have to offer as many as 15 subjects with an average of 8 to 10 periods per day, there is no gainsaying that it will be a near impossibility for these students to assimilate all the lessons or to grasp all key efforts. What about the changing global circumstances? Of no fault of theirs, most parents are becoming career-oriented and professionals. They don't have time for their children regarding their education. Most of them are not knowledgeable in the academic field. Their children need assistance. Hence, they can't assist. That is why it is important for these parents to pay for extra lessons so that their children can excel academically. Can you afford to ignore the balance in potential inequalities? In extra lessons, teachers begin by identifying strengths and weaknesses, learning style and personalities, so that they can best select teaching ideas and methodologies. In extra classes, teachers have enough time to prepare students for both internal and external examinations. That is why Loyola Jesuit College, Abuja, and Graceland International School have remained the best school in WAEC examination because of the extra lesson strategies conducted in their schools. Anything, I hope with this silent point of mine, I've been able to convince you and help you see reasons why extra lessons should be encouraged in our school system. Thank you.
So now, we're going on a short break. When we come back, we'll have the first supporting speaker from the proposing and the opposing side. Thank you.
Growing Up is a program that promotes value-based education and noble moral standards in the upcoming generation, as they are the leaders of tomorrow.
If I may ask, is deforestation really the major cause of climate change?
Yes! No!
Volcanic, isn't it? I love that.
Growing Up, a debate special and unique.
Growing Up, raising young minds for the future.
Welcome back. The program is still growing up. Thanks for being there. Growing up.
Great integrity.
Great integrity.
Dignity for all.
Thank you. Now, let's listen to the first supporting speaker from the proposing side.
All protocols duly observed. I'm Maureen Stephen, a student of Antibasi College, and I'm here to propose the motion which says extra lessons during holiday periods should be discouraged in a school system. A wise man once said that if the purpose of a thing is not known, abuse is inevitable. Our school system should not in any way be abused by the introduction of extra lessons. Extra lesson is a time for holidays, is a time for rest, relaxation and refreshment. During this time, students can read books for fun rather than to resort to spark notes for chapter summaries and character description. It's a time where students have to relate with their families and friends, pick up new area of interest, pick up old hobbies, and expand their social horizons. It's also a time where students tend to be more creative. Extra lessons poses real danger for children, and it makes them feel like they're drowning in torrents of information. Dr. Jim Taylor, a neuroscientist, calls this notion cognitive overload, and it happens when the inflow of information hinders rather than help a student's ability to process information and think clearly. Information overload affects children negatively, as it doesn't allow them to process the information they are given with. Also notice that during extra lessons, there are no fresh information provided, as the information they are providing is just a revision of what they were taught in normal school session.
Excuse me, point of information.
Yes, please.
You made mention of the point that anything that doesn't have a benefit is not important. Or how did you put it?
I said that a wise man once said, when a purpose of a thing is not known, abuse is inevitable. And our school system should not be abused by the introduction of extra lessons.
Thank you. Do you mean that you don't know the purpose of extra lessons?
Tell me.
Alright, that will be known when our speakers give their points.
As I might mention, extra lessons poses real dangers for children. And it doesn't have any real benefits but disadvantages. David Von Drege, who is the author of the Time magazine and the topic, The Case Against Summer Vacation, says that although holiday is symbolic for liberty and creativity, it's a time when it comes to holiday, it's a luxury we can't afford to miss. So it should say that holiday is very vital. The question is, how can we help our children swim against the tide of information overload? The answer is quite simple. We need to be the spyglass. We need to help our children and stop engaging them in extra lessons. The book Psychology Today states that rest prevents children from chronic stress, and chronic stress affects the ability of a child to have proper body functioning, heal injuries, and memory loss is also affected. During these extra lessons, be it either after school or after the school sessions during normal holiday periods, it's just considered as holidays. So if students engage in extra lessons, they won't have rest. All the information they are being filled up with can get lost. But if they engage in extra lessons, tell me, how would they do other small house chores? That's why when some girls get into marriages, their marriages end in divorce. With this following point, I hope that I'll be able to assure you, my audience, that extra lessons should be discouraged in our school system or abolished. Thank you.
Growing up.
Growing integrity.
Dignity for all.
I hope you all enjoyed that. That was educative. Let's applaud her again. Let's also listen to the first supporting speaker from the opposing side.
Permit me to stand on the existing protocol. I am strength in my audience. I'm here to reinforce the position of my lead speaker that extra lesson creates a sense of belonging. Extra lesson creates a more relaxed atmosphere for both bright and dull students to express themselves, thereby encouraging sense of belonging. Extra lesson is complementary to normal academic exercises. Yes, extra lesson is an effective complement to the regular academic schedule. In this wise, what could not be accomplished during the formal academic setting could be well offset during extra lesson. More so, there is close supervision. Extra lesson affords teachers time to supervise students' academic work closely, since extra lesson is not subjected to tight schedule like change of period at regular intervals.
whether a teacher finishes his lesson or not. Extra lesson is stress-free. It reduces tension and makes students feel relaxed in an informal setting. I believe in the adage that says an idle man is a devil workshop. Yes, engaging students in extra lessons will make them more focused on positive activities. Go ahead.
You made mention of extra lessons in developing a dull child. But let me tell you, all children were born blind. In fact, everybody were born blind. They develop his or her intellectual abilities. So can you mention one person that extra lesson has helped to develop that person so that his dull abilities can be developed?
As I go ahead, you hear the example of a person extra lesson has helped. But let me correct you. You said I made mention of the point that extra lesson develops a dull person. I said extra lesson creates a sense of belonging so that bright and dull students express themselves, thereby encouraging sense of belonging. I go ahead. Extra lesson builds confidence. Yes, during extra lesson, students can be motivated to try out more skills or take more risks academically, thereby boosting their self-esteem. Students who are academically dull are well accommodated during extra lessons because the formal maybe fear of classroom situation will be greatly reduced or completely eliminated, thereby making such students feel more at ease. I am a practical example of this. In my former school where there was no effective extra lesson strategy, I was shy to address an audience like this. But with the introduction of extra lesson in Confidence High School, today, here I am. Would you, my opponents, deny the academic assistance extra lesson provides for you? Homeworks which might have been given during the early hours could be tackled during extra lesson. It is now a common fact that homeworks create a friction between students who are academically dull and their parents, because the parents may try to explain homeworks while attending to other house chores. They try as hard as they may, the children do not still get the sense of it. But tackling these homeworks during extra lesson will make everyone's evening feel more relaxed and more fun, thereby making such students feel happy and their parents. The moderator, panel of judges, my co-debaters, and my wonderful audience, I hope with the cogent point I've raised, I've been able to leave you in no doubt and convince you that extra lessons should not be discouraged, but encouraged in our school system. Thank you.
Thank you. I'll call on the chief judge for the motion of adjournment to be moved.
It's a very interesting motion in the house today, and I know you really enjoy it. For next week, as we adjourn for today, we will really be interested in your point of information. We want every one of you to raise your point of information, because that is where you will get your marks. You are called upon, all of you, the debaters, to raise your point of information. Point of information is not just for one person. If you repeat a point of information, you lose out. But if every one of you attempts to say your point of information, it means you are focused and it makes the debate interesting. Thank you very much. Growing up,
growing in integrity.
Growing in integrity.
Dignity for all.
Thank you very much. My first agenda.
I, Victor Ben, a student of JS1 from Antibasi College, located at Uyo, hereby call for the adjournment of this meeting till next week. I so move.
Seconded.
I, Precious Ifeanyi of JS2 in Confidence High School, Ikotek Benin, I second the motion, so move.
Okay. Panel of judges. Accurate timekeeper, the moderator, thank you very much. And our teachers here present, thank you for coming on the program. To our viewer out there, I hope you have had a sore time watching us today, and I hope it has been a worthwhile time with us. We'll do this again next week. Of course, we've not finished the debate. The debate continues as you've heard next week. We shall see the concluding part of the motion, which says extra lessons should be discouraged in our school system. So, keep it with us, same time, same station. I am Emma Miriam Setufe signing out. Bye bye.